It's great to have BYU women's basketball head coach Amber Whiting joining us over Zoom as her team prepares to make Amber's first venture into the West Coast Conference Tournament. Coach, we'll get to the potential matchups here in just a moment, but at this juncture, how would you explain the mentality of your team coming off another tough loss and riding a losing streak into a tournament where it's March and anything goes?
I've tried to talk to my women about changing that mindset because we took tough losses, but that's over, right? It's March. March is everyone is 0-0. So let's go.
And certainly it's going to be fun. You're preparing for Pepperdine or Santa Clara, which will be the first game of the day. Certainly you have your eyes on that. What's the day like in terms of practice and travel to get down here for tomorrow's game?
We're going to just do things normal this morning, have film, practice, and then get ready to go because we leave, I believe, at 3:00. So we'll be able to have watched the game and kind of prepare our minds of what's going on down there when we get there. But it's really important for my girls to just lock in today of, you know, either game plan that we have and just be able to go.
What makes preparing for a tournament like this and the March Madness scenario, if you will, starting at the beginning of a conference tournament?
It's fun. Like, I have loved being able to just get in the war room with my coaches and like strategize of, you know, we did this last time with them. How does it correlate? How can we pick up? So we've watched, you know, I've even had it down to the guys squad. They're yellow for one team, green for another team. So then they can differentiate the different game plans. But it's fun. It's fun to just be able to, you know, this isn't when the magic happens. And so March is like, I don't know. If you are a basketball player, coach, whatever, this is when you get excited. So let's go.
Absolutely. And you know that firsthand, being part of the Sweet 16 team for BYU, making a run in March is really special. And everything you do this year certainly is the first for you, right, as a Division I coach. So how are you and the staff approaching what is your first and last, in this case, in the West Coast Conference, at least, tournament in Las Vegas? And it's not like you haven't coached in tournaments before, but now here you come in as a D1 coach.
Actually, like, the X's and O's part, I feel like are pretty, similar. Like, you're strategizing with your coaching staff, which is, I mean, normal compared to any other level. And so, and then I've played 3 games in 3 days. I've played 6 games in 3 days. I mean, whatever we've had, you just have to be able to tune out a lot of the noise and the extra stuff and just focus on the task at hand. And you have to take one game at a time. That's really, really important. One day at a time, 1 hour at a time. So it doesn't overwhelm you.
Amber Whiting, the head coach of BYU Women's Basketball, is on BYU Sports Nation. The first game of the tournament happens to feature the two teams that will play for an opportunity to match up with you tomorrow at the Orleans Arena, Santa Clara and Pepperdine. Let's discuss both of those teams, starting with Santa Clara. What makes them a unique team to prepare for as you get ready for the tournament?
Santa Clara is really good, and they're explosive. Tess Hill, who is the freshman of the year, she's really came on the scene and made some noise, and so we got to make sure we're taking care of her, and she is a good driver, a good finisher, a good shooter. Like, she has it all. They also have some bigs that can shoot, and so we got to make sure that you can't just sit in the paint. You got to get out and guard them. And so there's several things that make them who they are. And so we just have to, and they're different from Pepperdine. And so we just need to make sure that we're focusing on the things that we can control with them. We split with both teams. So it's, you know, it's whoever wants it more at that point.
Okay. And then what makes Pepperdine unique and different to prepare for?
They have a really, really good shooter, Stedman, and they also have some guards that can get downhill. They have bigs that finish around the basket really well. So they're not like a pick and pop type team. So we got to make sure that we are taking care of the paint, the one-on-one post defense, stuff like that.
What did you think of the all-conference selections from your team and where they were put?
You would go there.
um,
I'm trying to be nice right now. And Lauren is leading the nation in rebounds, men and women, so stats don't lie. So I have my issues with that, but she was first team. And Nani is first team too, and she brought it every single game. And, you know, she had a lot on her shoulders this season and handled it. So I was happy that she made what she made. Yeah.
Did you feel like Lauren should have been, obviously, defensive player of the year by herself and player of the year in the conference?
For sure, defensive player of the year. You know, I feel like when you get player of the year, you got to win. So we should have done better with that to help her do that. But defensive player for sure.
Does she utilize this, or will she utilize this in any way, do you think, to drive her even more? She's already a super driven athlete.
If she does use it, she's going to use it for motivation, of course, right? But I think Lo just, she shows up every day. Like, it's hard to get more out of her when she brings it every single day. And so, like, days that I don't know that there's been very many off days in my head for her. If she uses it, it's definitely for motivation. And if not, I think she just wants to win, though. That's my thing with her. And so that's what's always been really good about her. She just wants to win.
What's your life like right now as you have your daughter on the roster, obviously, and then Jace is doing a really nice job off a mission as a freshman to Boise State? Most of your tweets at this point are retweets of Jace Whiting content, right? He's having a great freshman year. What's life like right now as not only a coach, but obviously a mother of basketball players?
Amari's been in therapy and rehab and doing all of her stuff, and so she's been really working hard that way. It's nice to have her voice in the gym and just, like, her support. When you do it with – and she knows me. She knows, like, when, you know, I have a certain look on my face, like, it's not going to be a good day. And then Trent, like, we're eating, breathing, sleeping basketball. That's really normal for our family anyway. And Jace, I'm really proud of him. I mean, they just beat San Diego, which was awesome. And just being able, Trent was down there for that game. And they stormed the court. It was awesome. But then I got to FaceTime him while he was in the locker room and just, I don't know, feel his energy. Like, it's just so fun to feel. But we have our weekly Sunday night family FaceTime so that we can all talk and catch up. And I called him last night. I wanted him to give me all the stories, you know. And he's like, Mom, I'm tired. Like, we'll catch up sometime after season when we can all just have no phones, no, you know, distractions, and just rehash.
Now, obviously, Amari's coming off a pretty significant knee injury, and you mentioned she's in rehab and trying to get healthy. What's the timetable for her to be 100% so that she can be ready to go with BYU women's basketball next year and year one of the Big 12?
She had surgery in October, so her, like, full go is, like, July-ish. But we're just taking our time. It's more important right now for her, the strength, and to make sure that she's feeling that good, and they both line up and they're good equally. Jeff and Steven have been doing a great job, and that was the whole point in bringing her here early in January so that she could be with them. And yeah, she's killing it. And I don't get a lot of, like, the hands-on or get to be able to see her a lot as far as that's going. But I saw her, I heard her laugh, and it's a contagious laugh, and it's a loud laugh. And I had to look down the other day, and she's jump roping for the first time, and she was like, you would have thought, I don't know, they gave her a new car, but she was so excited. So that's good to see and hear.
That's awesome. Most of us don't look forward to jump roping, but in that case, coming off an ACL, certainly that's a celebration moment. What's your favorite? You mentioned March is magical. What's your favorite March moment in your basketball life?
Ooh, I love the upsets. Like, so when I used to teach, I would give, you know, all my students, like, the brackets, and we would all fill them out, and I'd put them on the board, and I would pull up March Madness on my overhead, and we would watch it every class, all class. But, like, the upsets, that's what's the funnest part for me. I just love being able to watch those, and I, you know, cheer for underdogs, and yeah.
What class did you teach, by the way?
U.S. history.
We would have wanted to be in Mrs. Whiting's class in U.S. history because we would have just watched March Madness all day. That would have been awesome.
You've just established yourself as the greatest teacher in the history
of all time of United States
school
higher education.
People didn't know what it was. Like, I remember passing it out. Somebody's like, "What's March Madness?" I was like, "No, you don't get one."
You get an F. Coach, it's great to have you on the show. Let's give you some BYU Sports Nation karma for your approaching elimination game tomorrow in the Orleans Arena. And we hope you have a fantastic practice. Safe travels down to Las Vegas, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you. Thanks, you guys.